It's great to have you back for devotions here today, and we're going to continue on the subject matter of how do you spell success. So I know some of you have been guessing these, so I hope you got this next one right. Okay, so we look first to salvation, then you need wisdom and understanding of the Lord, then you have to have character, consecration, that's dedication, entreaty. We looked at that yesterday, and that's actually praying unto the Lord. Okay, then service. So today I want to talk to you, first of all, about service. Let's look here, Isaiah chapter 6, verse 8. Now, what I want to tell you is, all the way back then, thousands of years ago, God had a problem getting people to serve him, like we have problems to get people to serve God today. People want to hear the word of God, but they don't want to serve God. Look in this passage. And Isaiah said, "And I heard the voice of the Lord saying, who am I going to send? Who will go for us?" God knows nobody wants to work for him during a troublous time. Then I said, "Here I am, send me." You know, there's no excuses for people not serving God. Now, this is really becoming a problem ever since this trial that's been going on here in America, ever since the spring. We have people, we have maybe a third of the people that are willing to serve God. Everybody's all scared and nervous. Hey, listen, I got news for you, and I mean this. As a child of God, you ought to be smart, but you ought not to be scared. Listen, I would rather die than be known as some coward that wasn't serving God. So I want to encourage all of you to get back to serving God. The way in which we conquer is continuing, not hiding under a rock somewhere. Now, I always say this. I know that there was a better minister who could have done a better job than me here in Pittsburgh. But guess what? He didn't show up for the job. So God got stuck with me. If God doesn't have a good hammer, then he's going to use a shoe. But listen, if you want to have good success, then you ought to serve the Lord. Okay, now, I'm squeezing in two letters. Last letter of the week here. Ready? Is soul winning. I'm sure those of you who know me, that was going to be part of this here. Soul winning. Now, let's look here in Proverbs chapter 11, verse 30. It says, "The fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and whoever captures souls is wise." Listen, instead of building up your bank account, instead of having a really big 401k, instead of getting caught up in a whirlwind of people that are planning on having just a great life in their retirement years, but I believe in planning. Listen, you want to be banking things in heaven. You want to send money home to be with the Lord, doing the Lord's work. You want to be winning people to Jesus Christ. Because listen, the only thing that you can take to heaven is people. That's it. And so I want to encourage you to lead people to Christ. Here, the motto of this church is to win one more. That's the passion of the church, to keep winning another man, other woman to Christ, another child. I had a man run out of church last Sunday. So I was standing outside the door there. And we got in a little bit of a conversation, and I could tell that God was working on him. And within minutes, this man prayed with me to receive Christ. I mean, that's more important talking to people in the church. But somebody brought him to church. A soul winner brought him to church. That's what you ought to do. Listen, you can't get everybody saved, but you can get somebody saved. Looks like here in Daniel 12, verse 3. "And those who are wise," wise people, it says, "they will shine like the brightness in the sky above." The Bible says, you'll shine in heaven like a glowworm or something like that, okay? Look here. "And those who turn many to righteousness like the stars forever and ever." So people who are billboards for Jesus, they're always pointing people to Jesus. It doesn't say that you're the one that actually prays with them to receive Christ, but you're always talking about God. You're always trying to get people to trust in the Lord. Yeah, I remember some years ago, there was a man, he had a hardened heart. He led a rough life. I did his daughter's wedding. And so the day came in which just overnight he was dying. Well, he never wanted to come to my church. And I went in the hospital and I told him that he had to trust in Christ. And after I told him how to do it, he said this. He put his hand out and he said, "Let's do it." He was just waiting for somebody to tell him. Listen, there's somebody waiting on you to share with them. Oh, listen, I don't have anything else to tell you right now on success, but I'm here to tell you this, and I mean this with all my heart. When you walk in God's ways, then He will put you in position to be blessed.